Get ready to match the stars from Chips Robert Pine, Rhett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Stephanie Edwards, Bill Daly, and Fanny Blair as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Raymer.
Thank you, John. Thank you, friends. Got a very good audience today, John. Very lively bunch out there.
Stephanie Edwards, how delightful to see you once again. You look more beautiful than ever.
Oh, thank
welcome
you.
Back.
You have learned your lines well.
Thank you. And you do, old bean. Listen, we must all be
pine.
Nice to Charles. Old pine, I beg your pardon. We must all be nice to Charles this week because at the end of this week, he's going to Broadway to do a show.
Oh.
And we want to make sure that he comes back. So yeah. It'll be.
Right, you don't say show. It's like I'm in a nice show or a horse show.
Or a carnival or
it's
a circus.
Theater.
It's a play.
It's a play.
A live
you
theater.
You don't say show like it's some.
It's a play called Charlotte, and it's about Goethe. Goethe, he's the guy who wrote Faust, you know.
Sure.
You know the story about selling your soul to the devil.
Sounds too heavy for me.
And
it's a show about Faust.
It's a show about Faust.
I hope you get a better reaction in New York.
Anyway, it's going to run.
I want to thank you for the send-off. So moving.
We will miss you, Charles. I mean that.
I know. I love it. This is my home.
All right. Now, over here, we have Dick Quinn and Kimberly Booker. Would you greet them, please? Let's get acquainted with the two of you. First, Kimberly, tell us who you are and where you're from.
Well, I grew up in San Diego most of my life, and about 5 years ago, I came to Irvine to go to school, and I guess you can call me a dancing computer operator.
I don't know what that means.
Well, I was a dance major in college, but now I'm a computer operator.
Oh, that's
never mind,
too bad.
Sweetheart.
You mean you go to school all those years and knock yourself out?
Well, I haven't given up yet.
Oh, you haven't?
No, I'm waiting for my big break.
What? You do ballet and modern and jazz?
Ballet, modern, jazz,
you
Spanish.
Do it all, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Topless on Lassie Annigan.
Wrong.
Were you ever in a show?
Yes, I was.
Good luck to you, Kimberly.
Thank you.
And Dick?
I don't dance.
You don't dance.
I compute,
don't
but I was not going to ask you to dance, because my card is full.
Okay. I'm a recent transplant from Connecticut, and where I was a elementary school principal. And I'm out here looking for work, preferably as a talk show host, something like that.
Oh, good.
Game show?
Yeah, right.
Things like that.
They're very easy.
I heard.
Oh, listen, you'll be in work in 20 minutes, as soon as they see you on this show. Okay. Kimberly, A or B?
B for Booker.
B for Booker.
Booker?
Booker, that's her name.
B
for Booker, that's her name.
Take her pins out.
Ugly Ed is so ugly. When he went climbing on Mount Rushmore, it looked like Jefferson had a blank on his face.
Get Fanny to do her imitation of Joan Fontaine. No. Do your imitation of Joan Fontaine.
Imitation of Joan Fontaine?
Okay. Oh, very good.
That's it.
That's was it. A two. I'm sorry I asked you to do it.
Put get her to do her imitation of Dame May Whitty.
Huh? Put your thing in the slot. Oh! You all think right, I don't? Listen, I'm too busy supervising.
Ugly Ed is so ugly. When he went climbing on Mount Rushmore, it looked like Jefferson had a blink on his face.
Frown?
A frown? Frown. How would that? I don't know how that would work, but we'll find out here.
Well, it's not going to work here.
Not going to work there.
At station number one.
Yeah. A wharf would be good.
Oh, that's okay, Kimberly.
What did you say?
I said a big old ugly wart.
A wart? I suppose everybody's going to say that, right,
no,
Charles?
No, because I don't think a wart is a facial situation.
Yeah.
Is it?
Sure.
Certainly.
You can have a wart on your face.
Sure.
Abraham Lincoln.
Pimple. Would
pimple,
be.
That's right.
Yeah. Abraham Lincoln had a big old ugly wart on his face.
That's right.
Mole.
Right.
That was a mole.
Pimple, wart, anything like
we
that.
We can
all right, Stephanie.
Well, I joined the group. I'm sorry.
You said wart?
All right. Yeah.
She's looking for a frown on your face.
A Montgomery wart. Remember that story?
Montgomery wart.
That's funny, Bill.
All right, Fanny.
Wart.
That's it.
Oh, dear.
Did wart cross your mind?
Yes.
It did? And you rejected it in favor of frown.
Yeah.
Dick, Hal said, I am never going back to that weird doctor again.
Why not?
Why not?
He replaced my kneecaps with blank caps.
Some of them have had that experience.
Now, Dick, Hal said I'm never going back to that weird doctor again. He replaced my kneecaps with blank caps.
Hubcaps.
Hubcaps.
Like that, huh?
Hubcaps. Only one answer.
That's it? Hubcaps? Yeah. Well, usually there could be two.
Hubba, hubba, hubba.
Hubba, hubba.
Hubba.
Hubba, hubba, hubba.
Where's that saying from? Hubba, hubba, hubba.
It's a song that was popular in the 40s before I was born.
Hold on, slow this game down real fast. How about teeth caps?
Teeth caps.
It takes longer than that.
Nothing wrong with teeth caps.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't need this.
Teeth caps are
all
right.
I'm only getting stale on the show.
Anything
with
caps. All right, Fanny.
Well, I'd like to answer that question before I go into my answer. Where do they get hubba hubba?
Hubba hubba, yeah.
Years ago, when they used hundreds of extras in movies.
Right.
And they wanted to pretend they were talking, they would say hubba hubba. So you'd have 400 people going hubba 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 hubba. Now, I'll give you my answer. I like Joan Fontaine.
That's another two.
Well, I'm having...
Do that as Joan Fontaine.
No, I'm just having a small breakdown. It'll pass.
Thank goodness I'm going into the theater.
Oh, dear. I said baseball caps.
Baseball caps.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Well, there are a variety of good choices there. Well, he picked up four. That's the score at the end of round one. 4-0. And round two coming up after this. All right, now we'll go to round two, and Dick, since you're ahead, we'll ask you to go first.
Okay.
A
was okay last time.
A last time? Mm-hmm.
Adorable.
Who plays?
Did you hear us talking private stuff,
don't
Fanny and
right.
No,
you
what?
You didn't hear us talking freaking about our naturally frack red hair and how we admired it.
No, you're good. Both natural redheads.
Well, yeah, well, most of the time.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, you were the only
not
two who played
either,
in this.
Not from up here, not natural.
Oh,
red.
God. We got to play together.
Just yeah! Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is this,
yes.
Teddy said...
It's like a new game show.
Teddy said, I am never going back to that rotten nightclub. When I asked for a stinger, the waiter brought me a glass with a blank in it.
Uh-huh. Oh, cute. Cute question.
Dick, Teddy said... She's got to get... I am never going back to that rotten nightclub again. When I asked for a stinger, the waiter brought me a glass with a blank in it.
This time I'll go with B.
Yeah! It's B. All right.
B, he said.
He said B.
I'm sorry. And I can spell B and I can't spell scorpion, but if I put scorpion down, I couldn't...
Scorpion sting.
Well, that's a drink also, a scorpion.
Oh, is a scorpion a drink?
B sting.
Really?
Bees.
You barflies know all those terms, yeah, don't you?
Maybe I should have put fly down. That was...
What did you have?
Oh, don't boo. I was in the service. Scorpion.
Two scorpions.
Sorry.
Two boos. We have two boo-boos.
Two scorpions.
Two boos make a boo-boo.
Are you a Scorpio, Bill?
Yes, I'm a Scorpio.
Kimberly.
Yes.
4-5, 5-win.
Gotcha.
Game one. Pete said, you know you went to a really wild party when you wake up and there's a do not disturb sign hanging from your blank. Now we're ready for Kimberly. Pete said, you know you went to a really wild party when you wake up and there's a do not disturb sign hanging from your blank.
Your neck.
Your neck.
Uh-huh.
All right.
It's a wild party.
Said, hanging right around your neck.
It's a long neck. Goes right up into your nose.
Oh, nose!
Now tell me once more what the point of this game is. To match everybody, to
that's
get
the
matched,
whole idea,
and then the person
yes
wins.
Yeah, when she talks like that, you know she's matched.
Uh-oh.
Neck.
Neck, it is, yeah. All right.
I said ear.
Ear. Now, Kimberly, you got to match everybody in the lower tier to achieve a tie.
We don't have to show ours.
Stephanie, what have you got?
I'm so sorry. If I had neck and changed my mind, does it count?
No.
I was afraid of that. See, this was starting
no
to be an
easy. Dick wins the game. What do you have? Wife? What do you have? Play game number two, all right? I'm going to spin you off right now. There she goes. Now we'll spin the Superman sign around here for you. There's the wheel. We're all set to go. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. I think about blank. You get $500 for matching the answer they wrote down most often, $250 for the second most popular response, and if you match a third, you get $100. Three of the six stars can help you and stand out here where you can see them all and look them over and call on the ones who are trying to get your attention, not the ones who are averting your gaze.
People who are hiding, in other words.
Right.
Do we stick it in this little thing?
No. He'll call on you.
Just be a quiet, verbal Stephanie, response. I've spoken
I'm so
to you
sorry.
Earlier
I'm a bit
about
slow.
That.
Brett?
Good.
I think about you.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Stephanie.
Me too.
Well, you can't say you. You've got to say something
said
else.
You,
I said
you. So you have to say something else.
I think about an answer for this question.
It might behoove you to watch this show before you come and do it.
Yeah, a couple of weeks have gone by and I've lost track.
Right.
So I got to come up with something right now.
Yeah, but it's a verbal. You don't have to write it.
Here, Stephanie. Stephanie.
Yes, Fanny. Life. Thank you, Fanny. Life. I think about life.
All right. One
and
more.
Charles.
I think about sex.
Yeah.
Don't get misled. Don't get misled.
He doesn't do anything about it, but he thinks about it. Sure.
Thank you, Bosun. Now, I think about sex, I think about you, and I think about life are the three they've given you. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I think about you.
Yeah.
You.
Good boy.
You agree with his choice.
Yeah.
The sun comes out.
Now, I'll bet you a nickel individually that I think about sex is going to be up there.
No.
Yes. Yes. You don't know who we had here that day. All right, let's take a look at the $100 response.
Wow.
I'll tell you who we had here that day. Well, then
no,
again,
we
maybe
didn't
I'd
have
better
this
not.
Bunch from San Francisco. They never entered the studio then. All right, let's take a look at the $250 response. There it is. Okay, Chuck. Last chance.
Got you covered, Gene. Got you covered.
All right. Thank you, friend. Now, here is the $500 response.
Yeah.
There it is. You got it. Adam Boy. I'm just kidding. There's your $500. That means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount or $5,000. However, you will spin the star wheel, and if you're lucky, you'll get to play for double that amount or $10,000. So step right up there and give it a whirl. And it must make one revolution, and we'll all root for a double, and here we go.
Right.
We'll all root for the whole double.
Double, 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 double,
double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, double, Blank Decker, D-E-C-K-E-R. Blank Decker. All right, Dick Quinn. If you give us the answer that Fanny's written on the card, we'll give you the $5,000. Simple as that. What do you say to that?
Double Decker.
Double Decker. Double Decker. Fanny, Double Decker's his answer.
I went to school with this guy named Donald Decker, and that just...
Donald Decker?
Double.
You wrote Double Decker. Here we go. Ready?
Sure.
All right, Kimberly, you're up first, and you can have A or B.
I'll stick with B.
B it is. B says, old man Purvis said, there's something wrong with my pacemaker.
Mm-hmm.
Every time I sneeze, the blank goes on.
What goes on? the black goes on.
Yeah. Just a quick study. You should be. You should
in
be
the a, theater.
You should
yes.
be a Broadway
I
actor.
I used to be in shows.
Yes.
Now I'm in the theater.
Yes. Have you ever done a Broadway show?
He's a very. I hope he's a quicker study than he is a reader.
He has no lines in the play, Charlotte.
Thank heavens.
Patty Duke didn't have any lines in The Miracle Worker.
She was cute. Kimberly, old man That's Purvis good, said there's something wrong with my pacemaker. Every time I sneeze, the blank goes on.
All I can think of are the lights.
The lights?
Uh-huh.
All right. That didn't occur to me. What occurred to you?
No, it didn't occur to me either. I put alarm.
The alarm?
No.
Okay, Bob.
I'm going to have to send you, put you back in uniform,
honey,
and put
on
you on a motorcycle and get like you the that, hell out of here. There, what
boy,
do you say?
Oh, honey, every time that the radio goes on.
Radio, sure. Radio, TV, all that
I think
stuff.
This is a match. I said the warning light goes on, which means he has about an hour and a half.
All right. You said the word light.
So that's one for Kimberly.
What do you got, Miss Stephanie, honey?
Well, I was slow to my answer because I was asking Bill who the dumbest person who ever did this show was. I was feeling a little intimidated until he told me he's the dumbest person who ever did the show. And
that's right, true. Right.
I said light.
Aha! Aha!
Going along that I am the dumbest one, I said TV, so that's what they're...
No, TV is good. TV
our dog used to jump on the bed. Every time a dog jumps me, jumps on the bed, that the TV goes on.
Really?
Yeah. Isn't that interesting? Let me get into that.
Maybe you shouldn't do
this. This is not
going to
be my opening story in the Johnny Carson show tomorrow.
No.
I can do the dog jumping on the bed TV right. story. That's not going to be my opening.
No.
All right. You're doing that, are you?
Yes. Yes.
All right, Fanny.
Gee, I wish I had a funny story like that.
Witty like I am.
I just say TV and that
yes,
was all.
That's it. Okay. Now, she's got two. Dick, let's see how you do with your first rounder. Two is not bad for a first round question. Teddy said.
Teddy.
When I was born, my parents kept me in a barn.
Oh.
For years, I thought I was a blank. About ready, Chuck?
Good job. Come along. He's doing his artwork. He's doing his artwork.
Ready,
he doesn't have time to put his card in the slot.
Teddy said, when I was born, my parents kept me in a barn. For years, I thought I was a blank.
Horse.
Horse. Well, I suppose anything that you'd find in a barn would be all right to respond to this.
I have been told that you don't find these in barns, but...
No, you don't keep pigs in a barn. You keep pigs in a pigsty.
Very special pigs you keep in a barn.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Are you a farm boy?
Prize pigs you keep in a barn.
Wait, did you grow up on a farm?
Yeah, Scarsdale, New York.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah.
So, you know,
big
that's
farm
big,
country.
Big
yeah.
Farm country.
Raised a lot of corn
right.
and all kinds of
things.
Fanny
had the best answer, and she threw it away.
Yes.
She said, Jesus.
That's right.
For years, she thought she was just... Thought it was a bull.
A bull.
They keep those in a barn with the cows.
No.
You know the phrase, eat like a pig, is wrong because pigs eat correctly. You can leave a week's supply of food for a pig and they will not eat it right away. They will eat it as the week goes on. I bring out all this book in Outdoors and You, which will be on the sign.
Another interesting pair.
And the correct answer, as usual.
Horse. Horse. One for Dick. My parents kept me in the barn for years. I thought I was a what, Stephanie? A cow. You do keep cows in a barn?
I went for Moo Moo, sorry.
Another cow, Fanny?
Well, I had a choice between a cow and a horse. I guess that's the reason I don't ride so well today. So I said cow.
Cow. All right. So it's 2-1
Good.
At the
Let's
end of round one.
It.
Two for her, one for you. Now this for you. 45 minutes
seconds.
To Broadway
yeah.
was the name of a tune in an old Broadway show.
Also was the name
by
of the
George
show that
M.
a tune
Cohan.
Came from.
That's right. Who was in? Who starred in that show? Trivia.
Charlie Crotchwell.
No.
No.
I don't know who starred.
You know.
No. All I know.
You know?
What was the show?
What was the show?
45 minutes of Broadway.
All I know.
George
James
M. Cohan.
Cohan.
Right.
George
right.
M. Cohan.
Right. George M. Cohan.
Cohan.
45 minutes from right. Broadway.
You learned something. At
and I'm still mad at the director for his attitude doing our promos earlier in the day, and don't think I've forgotten it.
All right. Let me see what kind of a tight shot he's going to get of you now.
Me too.
Yes.
Go off. We were treated abominably.
Yeah.
I personally call Mark good.
Do a little soft focus on Charles to make him look younger. See how much younger he looks?
I don't need this. I'm going to be in a show.
You're going to be. Charles is going to the theater to do a play called Charlotte.
Thank you.
All right. We'll all be here tomorrow on The Match Game. I'm Gene Rayburn. Emily. Thank you for joining us. You were all wonderful.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.